welcome to the Creative Classroom. We are on day 8 of spring crafting, and we are still loving it. And we've gotten to the stage where it's time to do a little cleanup. So I'll get into that in a minute. I am Kim Kesty. So again, welcome to our video studio here. But I'm not alone. I have my co-host, Nicole.
Hello.
Happy Wednesday.
I know I need to get a better filler here. I'm like, here. So happy Wednesday. Reagan calls this Wacky Wednesday. I don't know what's wacky about it, but I'm sure we'll figure something out.
There must be something wacky going on somewhere.
I think there's a lot, actually.
Maybe it's here.
Woo. Time will tell.
And we've also got Roy behind the controls back there. Hi, Roy. Are you wacky today,
Hello.
Roy?
I'm sure. I'm wacky.
Sure, why not? Okay, so as I hinted a minute ago, a lot of us have been in the crafting mode, hopefully for a few days now. And sometimes when you craft for 2 or 3 days, anyway, this is my experience, you kind of make a big old mess. Then it's like, whoa, 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 time to back off, clean up the space, start fresh. And one of the things that I like to do is really kind of organize my scraps. Now, this is going to get real right here because I am showing you my actual real scrap basket, and Nicole can vouch for me.
Yep.
This sits in one of my drawers in the craft room, and it's kind of organized, I guess, sort of organized. We did this probably, gosh, over a year ago, maybe even 2 years ago, kind of went to this system where I had this long, low basket, and then we just throw our scraps in as we use them in sort of-ish, rainbow-ish order, but anyway, pinks and yellows, blues, greens, and then we go to my neutrals in the back right here. So it does kind of work. It's worked for a while for me, so this may be something that you might consider. Now, I do a step 2 in my scrap process, and I do this not that often because I don't have time that often, but every once in a while I will come to this scrap bucket and then I will kind of briefly go through and, like, for instance, I'll grab this cardstock because it's a little bit bigger piece, and I'll grab this one. Ones that I can look at and kind of assume without measuring too hard that they will make card bases. So these are obviously bigger scraps. You know, I'm not going to reach for tiny things like this. I will use those for projects. But for example, I'll take these 3 out and I'll just do this for funsies. And then when I measure them and go ahead and fold them, which I'll show you what I do, I put them in this little basket. These are like a little Fun Stampers Journey storage baskets we have had. Don't even know if we have them anymore, but any little square tote, but you can see that I've taken scraps and then I've went ahead and cut them into just a standard A2 card base. Oops, that one's upside down, and pre-folded them. So everything in this basket is either a card base in all of our different colors, or once in a while I'll put in a panel, you know, that's just trimmed kind of like as a card front. So these are not folded. These are just small panels that would be great for, you know, layering, for mats. They're pretty darn good for, you know, trimming down to whatever size I want. So I kind of keep those there, and then any super teeny scraps that I know are going to get lost in here, I just kind of throw in the rest of this little shoebox type bucket. So it's not fancy, it's not, you know, anything that's rocket science or anything, but I thought it would be fun to share at least how I get those scraps off my cutting table and my area where I have my trimmer, and then into some sort of organization. So let me get this off the desk here, and I'm going to show you some fun things we do with scraps. I'll just quickly do one of these for a card base. So I would just take my trimmer, you know, going back to how I grab those stacks. So I know that 5.5 is my card base. And then I'll trim it down so I have one little strip left. And then I'll grab this guy and just fold it into a card base. And probably if I had a whole bunch of them, I would come and, you know, score them and make them really nice. But the crease tool is awesome for this too. So again, there's just a card base. I'll flip it in my basket. And it really doesn't take long. You can go through and go through a huge stack of paper and, gosh, just a few minutes.
Kim, you make folding card bases look really easy. And I know it should, in theory, be really easy. But I struggle. I don't know if I'm the only one out there. I just really struggle.
Using so getting them, like, straight, do you
yes.
struggle
well,
with?
You've seen it. I mean, you've seen it. It's sometimes important. I have to use this. I almost have to use the scoring tool.
Right, right. So. And what's great is that our trimmer, if you do have the Fun Stampers Journey trimmer, I think a lot of trimmers even have the scoring blade. So maybe you don't have a fancy scoring board like we also offer. But take advantage of that scoring tool also. And there's no shame in that. I guess I've just gotten to the point where I just have done so many card bases that it's like, fold, you kind of have to hold the two corners square, you know, and then just crease it real good. I don't think I have any other tip besides that.
It's just magical the way you do it.
Take advantage of your scoring blade.
Yes.
And then the grid, obviously, on your trimmer is going to keep everything straight, hopefully. But yes, so super great way to just use up a bunch of scraps. So what I also grabbed then when I was digging through for today's video, I thought, well, in the spirit of spring crafting, let's just grab some spring colors. And I just kind of go through and I'm like, okay, do these look good together? You know, is the orange too dark, too light? I had the brighter yellow that we have called Lemon Drop, but instead I switched it to Pineapple Smoothie. So a lot of times it's just trusting your eye. If you don't have a good eye for color, you can absolutely go to so many different fun websites or go on Pinterest, and they have all these great color combos. In fact, if you go to a Pinterest type site and you just type in color combo, not even kidding, you're gonna get so many great things. You can type in tropical color combos or spring color combos or anything like that. So at Fun Stampers Journey, we have about 50 some cardstock colors. So luckily, I think in a way, I don't have as many to choose from. I know some of you out there, I can imagine, have way more than 50 colors of cardstock. But again, when you're dealing with scraps, it's like, use what you have. Don't go and cut a full sheet of cardstock. You know, grab what you have, make it work. So that's what I've done here. And then I've really just come in and trimmed. And this is going to really make your scraps go far. You could cut these super quick. These are just half inch strips. So I've just taken all my colors that I have right here and just cut a bunch of half inch strips. One thing I like to do that I've showed before is actually just take one color. I'm going to grab my little card base here. This is actually cut to be the size of a card mat, so it's 4 by 5 1/4. What's really stunning too is just to take a single color and just adhere stripes of the same color all the way down. For this particular card, I did a bunch of different colors, but that's so super quick and easy and actually turns out stunning. It's almost like making your own pattern paper. I love it.
So Lori said she's been organizing her craft room and found tons of scraps, so this is great. I bet there's a lot of organization going on right
Absolutely.
Now.
One other thing I like to do with scraps, which I didn't bring here, it crossed my mind earlier than I was packing up for this demo, and I did not bring it, but we have some great punches too, and I know you guys do at home too. So another super fun way is to just grab your punches, even if it's just circles. Like, do this same thing that I'm going to show you right now with dots. Make all your polka dots, or punch little butterflies, or punch little hearts, or anything like that. And that's really a fun way. And that's a good way to get the kids involved. Ooh, Nicole, this is a good one.
I just thought that.
Let's get our girls to start punching a bunch of shapes.
Yes, I need to do that. Because Regan is actually getting to the point now where she expects a card kit every morning when I leave. So I was frantic this morning. I didn't leave her one, needless to say, but I will be doing that tomorrow.
Okay, now you can use whatever adhesive you want. I was just kind of looking here to see if I had my white liner, and I don't think I have it. Our white liner is thinner strips, but of course you can use any adhesive you want. Just lay down a strip, and you could even use wet glue. I think that works really well too. Now when I start laying these strips down, I'm just kind of eyeballing the spacing. Now if you want, you can do the spacing, you know, measure it a little bit more, be a little bit more precise. You can even use the grid if you have a glass mat or a grid surface for your project. Going sort of in rainbow order, not really. But rainbow order is always a classic too if you're kind of wondering, oh, I don't know what order I should go in. Trust the rainbow.
That's a good tagline.
Switching up a few things as I go along, but let's see, let's do lighter blue. Ooh, and I'm actually, I spaced these out a little bit different than my first card. That's hilarious.
The green get ignored?
The green got left out of this one. That's okay. I'll show you the original one I did. But this is so easy then, because you have all your extra strips, and the best way to get these nice and straight and trim on the back is just flipping your card over, and then your scissors can go really snug up to the edge. You don't want to cut that cardstock, the white one, but you can just go ahead and trim these away. So easy. And again, half inch strips, you could experiment with 3/4 inch. Skinnier ones would be fun. Those would be like, probably you'd want to use like a wet glue if you did really skinny drops. Actually, I don't even think it needs a green. So cute. So I went ahead and grabbed one of my circles. I store my dies in these little storage pouches. This is one of our classic circles, scored and pierced circles from Spellbinders. And I've got actually one die cut already here. It's got this sweet little score line around it. Hopefully you can see that. Yeah, I think you can kind of see that on the video. So it just adds just a tiny bit of detail that I think is fun and fresh and pretty. So I'm going to pop the circle in the middle first, and then I'm going to do a little stamping. Now, once you get this far, honestly, you could go any direction. You could keep it super simple and just do a sentiment on here. That would be just super pure and simple. You know, maybe do a die cut sentiment or a little bit bigger encouragement phrase or anything, a little bit like those cards I showed you yesterday. But this time I'm going to take one of our classic kind of shapes, I think, for card making, and that's a butterfly. So this is the Small Things die set, or stamp set. It does have the matching dies, which I have in the envelope here too. But this is great. This has just got your classic butterflies. Actually, this one would have been cute too on the circle. I ended up doing this one. I know, you look at me like, I think I need to do more than one of these cards for sure. But I'm just going to stamp it in black licorice. Get it really well inked up here. And I'm actually, because I have so much color action going on the color of the background of the card, I'm not going to even color this or do anything to it. You absolutely could if you wanted to, but I don't think it needs it. So I went ahead and added this guy to circle already. Actually, I'm going to use the circle for my other card. I forgot I adhered that butterfly already. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Some foam squares because I like to pop it up. And again, maybe I'll go at a little bit of an angle just to give it a little bit more interest. And you can kind of work the paper and fluff those wings a little bit if you want to. And then really it's all about adding it to the card base. And I'm going to put a really simple sentiment. By the way, here's my one with a green. So cute. So green, no green. What do you guys think? I don't know. It doesn't really need it. It doesn't end up being even at the bottom because when you trim it, you know, for the card top. So maybe this one looks even better.
Maybe.
Has the white end at the top and bottom. You could pop this up, but I would probably just go ahead and adhere it to my card base.
We had another tip from Kathy.
Fresh, right?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
No, no, I want to hear the tip. Let's hear it.
She uses her scraps to foil greetings using her glimmer.
Ooh,
So those speaking little everyday of. Greetings and stuff, that's perfect. And then she has a little bin for cuts just for that. Which is perfect.
I love that. Like, so glimmer a whole bunch of sentiments ahead of time and just have them in. I've never done that. That is a great idea.
Because that actually is really smart. While you have the machine warmed up.
Exactly.
Knock a bunch of them out, and then you have it. Yeah, I like that.
Perfect. Good so tip. I didn't do extras, but I did two glimmer sentiments for the two cards I'm going to share with you. I did them both with this really classic glimmer set. It's Everyday Sentiments too. And I don't know, these sentiments are just awesome. They've got all your birthday thinking of you, just a note. Friendship, shine bright, love, love, love. And I also love that this has the strip, which I think all of our sentiment ones do. They have the little dies that cut the perfect little strip. Mm-hmm. So once you get to tiny little strips like this, you don't have to like worry about measuring or whatever. So I thought this Hello Friend was fun. And again, I can go here. Now I can decide, do I want it, you know, off to the side? Do I want to put it right on top of the butterfly? No, I think that's too... I'm going to cut a little angle right here.
Okay, Audra's going a little cray-cray because she is she's giving me what I believe is the scientific name for the butterfly.
Oh!
Which I cannot pronounce. Diathrea climina.
Well, there we have it posted on the...
Oh, there it is. Yeah. Oh, Audra. You're so
smart. Fancy.
And Michelle
maybe
said,
this will be the quiz, Audra. What are these other two butterflies?
Oh.
Actually, this one, I think someone once had talked about this one. Actually, looks a little bit more like a moth. Doesn't it look like a moth?
A little bit. Some moths are really pretty, though.
They are. Well, yeah, that one's adorable.
Michelle said no green. She's
She likes the no green.
She likes
okay,
the no
good.
Green. Yep.
I kind of think I do, too, now that I made it. Now you can kind of trim this guy to, you know, go wherever you want. I just put the little angle. But just fun, super sweet, super simple. I do want to share one other color palette that I did. Bring in my scraps. That I've got it already glued down. But I kind of went with, for this one, just grabbing kind of a monochromatic palette a little bit, mostly blues and shades of green. So I thought this was a fun one for, you know, a little bit different way to go with your card. So again, I cut all my little strips and then I adhered them to my card panel. And this time I did end up with 7 strips, I believe. 4,
ooh,
5,
that's
6,
fun.
7, yeah. Isn't that kind of fun?
Yeah.
And I didn't even really try to go like light to dark. I was like, don't overthink it. Just put your strips down on there. You know, don't put the 2 light ones right next to each other. But I thought, you know, fun. If you really wanted to get super technical, you could do that. Put them light to dark, but don't think you need to. All right, and I'll put my same little circle. And this time I brought in one of my favorite, and I think it's one of Nicole's favorites
it
too,
is.
Flower
my go-to.
Swirls.
Mm-hmm.
Just a classic, simple, gorgeous flower. And what we also love too is it has the matching dies to cut out all the little, you know, even the little extra elements and whatnot. Here's the 2 stamps that I used. And ta-da! I already have them die cut and stamped and die cut. When I went to go put these on, I was like, I think these might could use some color, but I'm not sure. So you guys see what you think. I'm gonna pop them on here. And then you tell me if you think they need a little color. Because this is a little quieter in the back, that's what made me think. So I'm going to put my 2 leaves up a little bit, and then this little branch is going to almost look like it comes out from behind the leaves. So just a little tip for placement. Those 2 guys can hang out like that. I don't know. I kind of like it like this too, though.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shoot. So you could come in maybe with a little bit of watercolor, color pencil. Maybe you just want to color it fairly lightly, not really go cray-cray. And for this one, I did the Just a Note sentiment. So I won't pop that on and do all that, but here's my card base, and I will finish this after we do the finish the video today. But 2 pretty different looks, right? Still the same technique, the same idea, just your basic black stamping. Pick your colors for behind, add your fun little sentiment. So easy, so quick, and a great way to use up your scraps. I love it. So we are gonna come back tomorrow. So far, we're unscheduled to be back in the studio tomorrow and Friday. So we have some fun things planned and even something, I think, extra fun for Friday.
Yes.
I am going to be bringing Pan Pastels back in on Friday. I don't know about tomorrow. I haven't decided what I'm going to bring back tomorrow. But I hope these videos are helping inspire your crafting as you are home. A lot of you are on, what's it called again? We haven't
shelter
done it yet.
Shelter in place.
Shelter in place. Yeah. Yes, I need to get my technical terms yet. We haven't had to do that yet in Arizona, but we are being very careful, and we're keeping it far apart. Really, most of our office is working from home.
Mm-hmm.
So we hope that we can continue to come in just for a few hours in the morning and touch base with you. And I hope you are all doing well. Check out our website at spellbinderspaperarts.com. Maybe we'll say bye to Nicole and bye to Roy. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks a lot. Take care.